Connected to Jen.
Feel so lonely.
That was my fault.
Hi, Jordan.
Hi.
Hi, Lauren.
Hi,
Tina.
It's me.
Let's just try to listen to the music.
Listen, Jordan. Listen to the music.
Yeah, listen to the music.
Keep going.
How could you be so honest? Oh, how could you be so honest? Talking, baby, let's just knock it off. They don't know what we've been through. They don't know about me and you. So I got something new to see, and you just gon' keep hating me, and we just gon' be enemies. I know you can't be me. I could just leave it wrong, and you can't make it right. I'm gonna take off tonight. And
hey, Jennifer.
Cold story ever told. So we'll fall along.
Listen to Jen. Ready?
I would love to hear your poem.
All right. This one's called The Moon.
Ooh.
The Moon. A silver beach ball tossed up into the sky. You protect every night, reflecting and orbiting. A huge red crimson ball of fire. You control the sea with your power. Stays in at day and comes out at night. Are you nocturnal? Is there life on you? Neil Armstrong took one small step for man and one giant leap for mankind. There was a flag on you. Why isn't it blowing? Maybe one day I'll find out. One day I'll see you. One day I'll meet you to discover and learn. Stay still. Boom. It's all done.
Did you write it? That's awesome.
Wow.
Very nice.
Nice.
That's
amazing,
Alex.
Wow.
Was
I got that.
That was wonderful.
Job, I got that from the internet.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Wow.
I just,
that's awesome. That's good.
Wrote it.
So did you, Alex, did you write that?
Well, I copied it from the internet.
Okay. So it was one that was on the internet that you enjoyed?
Yes.
Yeah. Wow, that is beautiful.
Well, I wrote down space poem, and it came up with moon.
Oh my God, that's a good to know. So we know.
I love that. I love how you're sharing these poems with us.
Hey guys, I found some Halloween lo-fi beats,
that's awesome.
If you could share them towards the end.
Yeah, we'll share it towards the end because we're going to talk about planning for fall after meditation, which things up a little bit. My computer's not really working for sharing videos right now, and that means that they're probably going to be choppy. So that's okay. They were just little fun videos, and you could watch them on your own time, but I'd rather spend the time after meditation discussing some fun activities that we can do, and I have a poll for you guys. So we'll just kind of switch it up. We can't always control the internet, but we can still make things fun.
True. Very true.
Now we can be flexing all at the same time.
Yeah.
Ooh, see you, Michelle.
Morning, Amy Carroll.
Good morning. Was that Lauren?
Yeah, that was me.
Yeah. Hi, Lauren.
Good morning, Amy.
Good morning. So today, I want to revisit what we did yesterday with a different drum. So yesterday I used the big Dharma drum, and today I'm going to use the medium Dharma drum. And we are on different flowers in my garden. These ones are white, and there's kind of a really cool purple one over here that I love. And there's a couple of bees visiting us this morning, so it's really nice to see. So let's take some breaths. We're gonna go 5 minutes today, and my timer is not wanting to start, so let me go grab my phone really quick. And we're going to go 5 minutes again. And today I really want us to focus on the breathing the whole time. Okay. You can close your eyes, put your hand on your chest, and you're just breathing in and out at your pace. And that's all. Yeah. That's all I want you to focus on today is just breathing for 5 minutes. You can look at, you can look at the flowers and focus on the flowers, but I really want this to be a breathing meditation where you're really focused on that breath, okay? I'm gonna go grab my phone so I have a timer that works because we're gonna go the long 5 minutes today. All right, I have my phone. So you're just going to be breathing, listening to the Dharma drum. You can focus on the flowers, but you're really focusing on your breath, because when we do the 10-minute one, it's all about the breath. So here we go. We'll take one breath all together, And then the rest of the video, the rest of the time of meditation, you'll be doing your own breath at your pace, okay? So let's do one breath together. Here we go. Breathe in. Two, three, pause, breathe out. Nice. Now you're breathing on your own. I'd like to hear the breathing. Oh, nice. I hear some. Here we go. And there's 5 minutes. take a moment, be with that for a moment. I told you there were a couple bees out here, and I have the Dharma drum sitting under the flowers that you see, and one of the bees actually flew down onto the middle of the Dharma drum. And he sat there, and I think he was enjoying the music. And he sat there probably for a good 30 seconds. And then he actually just walked right off. So I was playing on one side. So if you heard it kind of get a little odd, I was trying not
good
to
job.
Hit him.
That's good, though. It's probably
good. Yeah. Yeah. And he just walked right off. And now he's on the ground. And I want to show you guys him.
She may have been enjoying the vibrations.
Let's see.
And bees actually do sort of dance as a way of communication.
That's true. Wait, I don't see a bee.
Where's the bee?
Anyway, Amy, you froze.
She's still down there.
My iPad froze.
Oh, I did? Okay.
Well, can you hear me? Everyone, just to let everyone know, just because I'm afraid of bees, that doesn't mean I hate their honey.
Oh, that's good.
Afraid of bees, but I do love their honey.
Yes. Am I still frozen?
No.
Yeah. No. Well, kind of.
Okay, good.
You're normal now.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, yeah, it was just interesting how he came, hung out, and then walked off, and he's still down there. So, yeah. So I think he must have enjoyed the vibrations.
Yeah.
Really cool. So that was a really nice, nice meditation here.
We had some
friends.
Well, yeah, because my thing froze.
Oh,
no, and I can't find anyone. What? And I can't find my whole screen.
No, keep moving.
My internet is horrible. I can't. I'm a blank screen. It's still black. I can hear you guys. I can't see anyone.
Oh gosh,
That can happen. Sorry about that.
It's okay.
I'm gonna launch the poll and let's get into the discussion because almost 11:20.
This is hard.
Perfect. Thank you guys for meditating with me.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to.
Oh, that was very nice.
Which of these movies have you seen? You can pick more than one. Multiple choices.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So, I can't. My movie. I'm glad you put the date because I can't.
Yeah. Do you know which one it is? Because some movies have more than one, right?
Oh, Hannah Rogers loves the Addams Family.
Yeah. So we're putting the ones we've seen or the ones we want to see?
The one you
have seen before. Mm-hmm. You have. I've seen those movies too. Debbie?
What? I've only seen two out of all of these.
Oh my god, I've seen a lot.
I saw Monster House in the theater.
Oh, not no.
So have I, Jacob. So no. Have I.
Not
they're only like the ones I probably remember watching and meant to watch. Because I have seen Coraline, but that freaked me out.
No.
Nyla?
Okay.
I'm going to try my phone again. It's sad. I don't know why I can't see everyone.
You don't like the phone.
Can you see the lid?
Can you see me?
I did the polls.
Oh,
yeah.
I didn't see anyone. That's okay.
You didn't see the polls?
Yeah, she did. She did her poll.
And I saw the news.
Jacob?
No. Yes. Maybe I can try on my phone because I have a backup.
I do not see a poll.
Oh, do you? Okay.
And I saw
the some people's phones won't be able to do it, and that's okay. We'll talk about the results after. So, everyone that can see it, did you vote?
Yes.
I did vote. I did not see the results.
Oh, we haven't got the
vote. Oh, we haven't done the results yet, Ben.
Ghostbusters.
I'm just waiting for everyone else. Okay, so I'm going to end the polling now. So once I end it, I won't be able to put any more answers in.
No longer.
And here are the results. The Addams Family and It's a Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown were the two winners.
Wait.
And I have seen both of those as well.
Jeez. Oh, yeah.
So,
wow.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was the least, which video or which movie was seen the least?
Looks like Coraline and
Paranorman.
Paranorman.
I've seen Paranorman. It was a great movie.
It was a great movie, huh?
Yeah, it was pretty good.
And those are the two.
And it was stop motion.
Yeah, I really like Paranorman. Was interesting. It was stop animation, and it was just a little bit different.
And just because it talked about just because people are born different or born with special gifts doesn't mean we have to make fun of them or hurt them.
That's right.
Yeah.
You just gotta accept them for who they are.
Doesn't want to work.
I saw the womb.
Yeah, the zombies recognize the error of their ways.
Oh wow!
I saw the old version of the Addams Family and
oh my
the
god,
new
the Addams Family. Oh,
say,
I never seen
the Addams Family. Addams Family, the old version. It was very funny.
And oh, it's funny. I've seen both. Okay,
you mean the old TV show from the 60s?
Yeah,
I think so.
Did you saw the play, Debbie, the Addams Family?
No. The play?
Yes,
the play day.
Yep. Thank you for reminding me.
And I've seen the movie Hocus Pocus. I have that movie.
I think that's what I'm saying. I saw the old version.
Addams Family, of course you saw it.
I've seen Hocus Pocus, and it's a really good movie.
I think I saw the new version last year.
Hannah loves it. Hannah Rogers saw it too, the play.
Yeah.
Hannah Rogers?
Yeah, I remember Hannah Rogers saw the play.
Yeah.
I think Stuart saw it.
Yeah, and Stuart too.
It was
Stuart. You saw PCPA, yeah.
Yeah.
And no, I didn't see the play.
I didn't see the play.
I just saw the old version and the new version.
Oh, that's so cool.
That's so pretty cool.
Yeah. And PCPA, guys, they are doing some really neat workshops right now on Zoom.
Yeah, I've done some of them before.
My sister has one time ago.
Yeah, so I'm gonna check those out and see if there's something that we might enjoy viewing from them.
Do you know them? Because if you have a really good relationship.
Yeah, I do,
yeah.
So did my sister. She did it a long time ago.
Did she? Yeah. So
actually,
I'll look.
You guys, but I can hear you, so that's good. I'm right here. I just can't see you today.
I've done two of their workshops.
It's okay. Once I can hear you, I guess.
Did you, Tina? Yeah.
I can't remember what the first one was, but the second one was on painting.
Was on what?
The painting.
Painting?
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 Yeah, the, I can't remember what it's called, but the lady who does the painting, I know her son.
Oh, wow.
Nice. And
did you enjoy doing that workshop?
Yeah.
My sister did. My sister loved it. That was like a long time ago, though.
Designing.
Yeah. Sarah's done a few of them.
So
their
my sister,
summer.
She loved it.
Stuff. Yeah, they do really good stuff. So I'm gonna check into that, guys.
I saw their play. What's it called? I mean, they did like a parent thing, and you see them what they do. It's really cool. Mm-hmm. I just watched. It was cool.
Oh, I did the YPP.
Oh, my sister did the YPP.
Nice, Tina.
So did my sister. My sister did YPP too.
I did it twice.
So did my sister. She loved
that's
it.
That's great, Tina.
You know, know you did YPP when you were a younger girl?
Yeah, I was like 18 or 19.
So, not that long ago.
How you guys feel about the Hitty Weens movie night?
Yes.
Woo-hoo!
What is that? What does that even mean?
We're actually doing that?
Maybe.
Yeah. Oh. So the reason I asked you guys about these movies is because I'm trying to get an idea of what kind of content we will be able to play when we're there. So it'll be kind of like an afternoon or evening Zoom.
Let's talk.
It'll all be on Zoom. It's all online. It'll be in October, and we're going to plan it together as a team.
Because we're responsible.
It's your guys' movie night, right, and you're adults. Mm-hmm. And planning is an important life skill that we all gotta.
Yep.
All gotta practice, even me.
Oh, totally. But do we have to do this? That's the thing.
May I suggest some BuzzFeed Unsolved videos?
What do you mean you don't have to?
No, there's nothing here you ever have to do, but it's.
I thought you all guys like it.
May I suggest BuzzFeed Unsolved videos? Those are pretty funny.
It'll be a movie, like with a set running time. So we're gonna like create an invitation. There's gonna be a set running time of, you know, however long one of these movies is, whether it's 120 minutes or 2 hours, you know, whatever.
I'll tell my mom about it.
Yeah, yeah. So together as a group, we're going to pick the date. We're gonna look at the calendar. This will be down the line. We're gonna plan it together. So every couple of days we're going to get together as a big planning group and keep voting and keep talking, and we'll make an invitation too, so that way we can send it out to our families, you know, if they want to join you on Zoom, that would be cool too.
That'd be awesome.
That would be so fun. I think it
Debbie,
sounds
you can do it too, Debbie. Hey, Debbie, do you want to do it, Debbie?
Yes, I'm doing movie night.
Barry will probably want to watch it too. I'm sure Barry. Yeah. Too bad Penelope won't be there.
Oh, I've never heard of a Hidden Wings movie night before.
We're gonna try. Because we're talking about fall and fall activities and just different ways to make things fun, since we know that we're gonna be on Zoom for a while, right?
We're really getting
close to the end of summer. So we already had to plan ahead.
It is summer over.
Say that again, Lauren. I missed that.
Oh, we're almost near the end of summer.
You are totally right.
So it's got 1 week of summer left officially.
It's time to start planning for fall. Yeah, it's time to start planning. So that's what you do. You don't wait. That's what you do. You don't wait until fall comes and then plan. You want to try to plan a little bit.
Okay.
So what are some fun other things for fall that you guys
pumpkin milkshakes? Milkshakes again.
Cottage kitchen.
Nice, Jackie.
I've never done it before.
We could do a pumpkin spice theme. So maybe we do a milkshake.
Oh, we could draw a pumpkin. We could draw a pumpkin.
Okay.
I was thinking like draw pumpkins and leaves.
I know.
Okay. So drawings like leaves, acorns, pumpkins.
Yes.
Scarecrow.
Yeah.
Scarecrow. What if we did like a scarecrow challenge, you guys, where we made a scarecrow from stuff in our house?
Alright.
That would be pretty funny.
Yeah.
Ooh, I like that.
We got another idea. We can pretend to be war movie monsters.
That would.
Because I think I can do Peter Cullen's Predator thing. Like,
I have a picture.
That would be a cool drama thing. Horror movie monsters.
Does drama?
It doesn't all have to be drama, but it can be some drama in there.
What do you think?
What about Halloween poetry? Or fall poetry?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Oh, hi, Alex.
Hi, guys.
We could do our own poetry for Halloween.
Jeez, Alex, he scared me.
What scares me? We could do our
whispering,
poetry.
Alex.
We could make our own poetry.
It was good.
Yeah, we could do poetry that's like fall or Halloween themed.
That would be really
cool. Or Thanksgiving themed, because
Halloween
another...
Dungeons and Dragons.
Halloween.
Ooh.
I remember.
That sounds like fun.
I remember for Halloween when I, for my first year at Hidden Wings, we made like these little thingies. I think they're like hard boiled eggs with, I don't know, but we made like little spiders out of all limbs.
Do you mean deviled eggs?
Deviled eggs or spiders.
Yeah.
Oh, so that was cute.
I can find butter cracker spiders.
I can find like on YouTube, like for
that's artwork. Another cottage kitchen thing. We could make like spooky snacks. Oh, what if we did like spooky snacks?
Oh, I love it.
Yes.
Spooky snacks.
On a star dice, so we can.
Yeah, that's okay. Well, we have the whole month to celebrate, though, right? Like,
oh yeah,
Halloween.
So September's kind of like it's fall, y'all.
Halloween, I don't like Halloween much.
And then
next Tuesday.
Yeah, October's kind of like Halloween month.
I don't like to be scared though. Like, that's why I don't like Halloween.
Halloween.
We'll make it scary.
My nephew's birthday is next
month. Well, I'm always
scary
for Halloween.
Like
Halloween.
You like scary stuff. Some people don't.
I like Christmas.
Christmas is good too. We'll do another planning group for that. So this will kind of be a test Christmas. Run, you know?
Yeah.
Christmas. Wait, do you like Halloween or scary?
Jackie, it's about the monsters.
The scary contest
in November. I got some videos we could watch from BuzzFeed Unsolved. They aren't too scary. They're actually pretty funny. Like, the guys' is chemistry. It's just like the banter.
To watch them like during the noon groups and stuff.
Yeah, if you like, I can show you guys one.
Can you send me a list for right now while we're planning, and then maybe we'll have time to watch one at the end.
Okay.
Yeah. At 11:50.
Also, I plan on showing you guys a funny video during the lunch meet. It's a Peter Cullen.
I think we're just gonna do drama.
No, I'm talking about during noon.
I know, but lunchtime we're gonna do drama.
Yeah, they're gonna do. We're gonna switch it up and do a bit of drama at lunch, and then if you want to share a video, you could share it on the last 5 to 10 minutes at lunch.
Can we practice and play?
Yeah, we can. Yeah, whatever you guys want to do, we'll be out at 12:30 to 1. Lunch is only half an hour. Because I have to run a big errand for Jim.
Oh, that's fine.
Sure. And in order for me to be back at 2:15, I'll need to leave at 1. So I'm sorry it's a little shorter today, but
well, hey,
we need to finish our play. You have to finish our play, right?
What?
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We can with everybody that's there, so that would I think everyone would actually enjoy that, Jordan.
Yeah, can we finish that today or not today, but whatever you.
Yeah, we can. Yeah.
So
okay, cool.
So Amy and Jordan, when would this even be? Like.
Stay at lunch. So I will text you the link, Jacob. Remember how I said that the link would be different today because it's coming from Amy's account, not mine?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So that's all I need to do is I'll have to send you that link.
Okay.
Speaking
that'll
of
be
links,
cool to do that
here's,
is that
here's
okay?
Supposed to be self supernatural.
What is it?
Supposed to be self supernatural.
Oh, nice.
The show?
Very cool. Well, if you wanted to, I'm having trouble with screen sharing today. So
I'm having trouble today, too.
The last 10 minutes of today, that would be cool after we're done our discussion.
Okay.
Cool. So, guys, let's get to Stefan then so we can have time for Jackie's video. Any other fall activities, Thanksgiving activities?
Well,
I think cottage kitchen, we could almost do like a Thanksgiving food every week. You know what I mean?
I have a question for you, for all, maybe all of you guys. What do you guys usually do for fall when you're not on Zoom? And let's say the virus isn't going.
Well, that's
on.
The thing is we can't.
For fall? What do you usually
do? Yeah,
we
can't always think of the things that we usually used to do because a lot of those things involved going places and like
you can't
visiting
be upset
things.
People.
Tell me.
But we're going to have to think of new ways and planning new ways together to have fun. And that's why we're doing that right now.
Yeah, we don't want
to. So, like, you know, we could do, we used to make a scarecrow together.
As much as possible. Program, you know?
So we're going to have to find ways to make it neat, to make it interesting. So that's why I'm like, maybe we have a scarecrow competition individually instead of like as a group. I know last year we made a scarecrow for the Solving Festival.
Yeah.
We competed. So like this year, we may not be able to do that together, but we could do it separately.
We can draw our own monsters.
Yeah, we can draw.
Yeah.
Michelle's.
We could totally.
We could do a lot of different drawings and stuff, but. Yeah, it's just kind of a different kind of year. So that's why we're planning it together, so we can make it extra fun and stuff that you guys want to do. So, I like monster
time. We could just draw. I like, I was doing, like, we can do pastels for the trees.
You guys can do that. I'm probably not going to do that if you guys do that.
Okay.
We could use crayons, markers.
I'd probably use crayons.
That's a great idea, Jordan.
I love art, so I'm trying.
Oh my,
Jordan! Yeah, we do all kinds of art for fall.
I was so excited to do that.
Yeah, Jordan would really get along well with my younger sister because my younger sister likes art too.
Oh, we can get some comments. Yeah, I was doing. I'm really so excited. Like,
Well, pastels are really great because they definitely enhance the art. I feel like. Yeah.
I'm excited. We should definitely.
Yeah. Does anybody else have pastels in their house?
I
do. They're the soft colors.
It's really nice, though. I like it.
I don't know if
I mean, you don't have to use. You can use crayons, too.
The worst comes to worst. The worst thing I probably could use are probably either crayons or colored
pencils. Yeah, you can use crayons or pastels. Has it? Oh, maybe Alex, girl can teach us.
Alexandra.
Then yeah, I would love to.
Yeah, we can do that and like put a poem around it.
Oh, and that's a great idea. Like write out a poem and then have a picture in the background.
Yeah.
That's
a really good idea, Jordan.
Yeah, you could do like some fall leaves or something in the background.
Yeah. We could put in outbreak for the hour dark.
Columbus Day.
I think that's a good idea to do that.
I think it's great that you guys care about the people that care that wholeheartedly about the people that are at that Adderdag place.
That's
yeah, that's so nice. We have a lot of caring people. Well, another thing we could do volunteering stuff for this fall, and maybe there's some people that you know need someone to rake some leaves or do something that we could do social distance, you know, figure something out, ways to support our community.
I know. You
know? That's my goodness.
And we could also make cards. It would be awesome to make some like different themed cards for like Adderdag Village, and I don't know if Friendship House accepts anything.
I don't know. Actually, Friendship House doesn't. Those people don't get it.
Wait, what are those? Friendship. What type of house is that? Like what?
It's you know, for
supported living, I think. That's supported living.
Yeah.
This is where people can't get out right now. Both people could really use some support.
That's where Mammy's father
was. Yeah. We should reach out to that.
Well, my friend's house, Debbie. I don't think they don't.
Yeah.
What?
Well, we could look at making cards.
Yeah. You know?
I can talk to them.
I mean, my grandpa doesn't understand what's going
on. No, but it still makes them happy.
That's yeah, true. It's nice to put a smile on someone's face. Everyone loves getting mail, right? We all love getting stuff.
I do.
As long as it's not a bill. Right?
Oh, Teresa, that was maybe the best line you've ever said all year long.
Yeah.
Well, they're having a lot of troubles. They're having a lot of troubles there.
Mm-hmm.
One of the Merkel's having trouble.
What kind of troubles?
I'm like one of the person who works there who had COVID.
Oh, COVID?
They have to test everyone. Oh. They have to test everyone.
Okay.
Yeah. Really?
Negative, though. He came back.
So but I don't have COVID-19.
Yeah, no, so I'm not sure if they're not them. They're just, you know, because
my mom got tested for COVID-19 because of her stomach issues.
Yeah, sometimes it's like a precaution, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then you're negative. Coach said that he got tested
and
again.
Coach
he's
negative.
What? Yep, I just got tested again last week.
You're negative?
Yep, you all mean- negative.
Yeah,
good.
Yeah, my
it just shows, guys, that social distancing and actually wearing your mask and everything works, you know?
Yeah.
It works. I heard on the news that they should all be tested, like if the whole world should test it, so maybe the cases will go down.
Yeah, we want to get as much data as we can in order to create the best vaccine possible.
Oh, because totally.
Right now, we have such a small like sample size that is very hard to actually combat something because we don't have the actual data that we need. Imagine like trying to solve something, but you have only a fifth of information, guys. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you don't have enough information.
It'll be a lot faster if you guys all be all tested, so cases will go down.
Yeah.
I hope those cases go back down.
Keep practicing wearing our masks and staying
feet apart and social distancing and washing your hands frequently.
Exactly.
Everybody does that.
Like I said, it makes a difference because I've been going to stores and going to stuff and being out in the world, you know.
Me and my mom have done that.
My parents get food delivered to their houses.
Oh yeah, a lot of people do. That's okay though, if that's what they choose.
Come in.
Yeah. From the food bank people.
Have you guys tested?
Dad shop, we wear our masks.
Yeah. Everywhere we go, we wear our mask.
I do too.
You guys are being very smart.
I wear my mask, but my gloves no longer because it's too hot to wear gloves. My fingers will get swollen in them.
That's fine.
It's hard when I'm wearing a mask. I can't keep it on.
My God, my glasses hurt. It hurts. Like,
try putting it under your glasses.
It's bad.
I know, but I'm feeling I'm breathing my own air.
Well, Tina, as soon as we get a vaccine, you don't have to worry about it anymore.
Yeah. Okay. That's why we should be tested. Until
then, Tina. Until then, I'm sorry you're going to have to wear
this.
I mean, if I got it, I'll probably have no symptoms. That's probably, you're really healthy, you know.
Well, once the doctors and the scientists get the vaccine right and make sure that it's safe, they'll do it. They thought of the order of people they should do it on.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like first, or the first order is, first they'll do it on the people who are really sick. Like the ones who have COVID-19.
Uh-huh. Sure.
And then they'll do it on
my masculine.
And then second will be the elderly.
Right.
And then lastly, it'll be us. The younger.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm getting a flu shot too. My mom and I are in the fall.
Yeah. We are too.
I just hope there's like a flu shot
flu shot, though, everyone.
Hey guys, I'm trying to show you guys how to keep my masks on.
Oh, okay.
Sure.
Mask.
Uh huh.
And I just put it on over my ears, and then I use my glasses to keep it in place. See?
Yes.
Wow. You nice.
Glasses.
You know, Jackie, you actually look pretty good with that on. Not gonna lie.
So you tuck it under your glasses so it doesn't get all steamed up. That's great.
It also stays in place.
Yeah. You know, Tina, I don't like to wear my mask either, but guess what? I don't like to be sick, so I'm going to wear my mask, even though I don't like it.
Yeah.
It, right, Debbie?
Whenever I get my flu shot, is there like a...
You have
is to wear... Is there like a up the nose?
That's for COVID.
I don't know if they have that or not anymore.
No, that's for COVID. Flu shot.
Ask your doctor. Ask your doctor if they fist in the nose.
No one likes to snort their medicine.
Well,
because I don't like
them. Would rather they
I don't really want to have them poke.
Well, yeah. They're going to have to, Tina. If you don't have the nose thing, they're going to have. I'd rather have the poke than put the darn thing in my nostril.
If you could, Tina, if you do have to get the shot, hold Tweety and think about the most wonderful thing in the whole world.
Think about the Seahawks.
There you go. And you think of something that you just love, and then before you know it, it's over.
Yeah.
It doesn't last very long.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can do it.
Yeah, you... We all know that you could pull through anything.
Yes, you're very strong.
Tweety.
Yeah.
As long as, and you could bring Tweety with you.
That's right.
Here's how I got over shots. I have you guys know how I have a bad habit of picking up this hole in my belly button? Just my hand. Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
It's like sort of tube thingies of like, stomach medicine. I'm not 100% sure what it did. And that was kind of like a giant syringe. And eventually, I was like, I get these things in my stomach. I don't need to freak out over a needle.
There you go.
There you go.
Woo! That's how you overcome.
That shows that you're tough.
Yes.
And actually, I think I was just freaking out because I thought it was supposed to freak out.
Yeah.
That shows that you're brave.
And it shows that you're maturing. That's wonderful. Yeah. You're becoming a woman. You're acting more.
Hey, it works. Yay, I can see it. I can see everyone now. Oh my god.
Oh no.
Good.
Three times.
It's like
it took three times, but it worked.
You must have broke it or something.
It was probably something happened. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to, Rebecca.
By the way,
sorry, guys. It's the last 10 minutes. So, yeah, Jackie, go ahead and try to screen share.
I was going to give you guys a heads up that they do have some potty mouths. Like, there might be a couple of bombs. Are you guys okay with that?
Yes.
I don't mind.
Innuendos or other.
Michelle's not here.
We're all adults, so that's okay. But
we're
not innuendos
here,
or like.
Okay? We're adults.
Not that we're I recall.
Michelle's not here anyway, so it's fine.
Yeah,
if there's subtle
adults.
Ones, it's fine, but you know what I mean? You know what I mean.
I got my first thing to load to add to share computer sound.
Oh, take your time.
I got to do
click
that
time.
You have like 2 minutes for it to buffer.
Yeah.
That happened to me three times, Debbie. I don't know. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Share computer sound.
We'll talk to him during
all right, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
I'm Ryan, that's Brent. This week on BuzzFeed Unsolved, we're covering the real-life Men in Black. Are they real? Are they as charming as their Hollywood counterparts?
You know, watching Men in Black, I never knew it was based on a true story.
Today we find out. The Men in Black are typically described as wearing black suits, being expressionless, cold, sinister, and in some cases, inhuman. The Men in Black seem to only talk to two kinds of people. Those who claim to have seen a UFO, and those who research UFOs. They present themselves as part of a secret organization, sometimes even producing a white card with a crest and the word security on it. And in some cases, they refer to each other by number rather than name. They threaten and scare people into remaining silent about their UFO encounters and/or research. Think of them as the cleaners of the extraterrestrial universe.
How much black do they actually wear? Do they look like the men in black that we see in the movies?
We'll get into what they really look like later.
Once they pull apart their skin and the alien comes out.
Now that you know the basics, here are, in my opinion, the most terrifying reports of encounters with the men in black.
Is anyone else
the first ever recorded experience with the men in black came from Harold Dahl in June 1947. Harold Dahl was out on his boat in the Puget Sound where he claimed he saw six giant donut-shaped objects in the sky. One of the objects fell apart, spilling debris that killed his dog and injured his son. He took photos of the debris but said they were later fogged over by a man in black who told him not to speak of the incident.
They had donuts in 1947? How old are donuts?
What?
He said he saw donut-shaped objects in the sky.
That's what you were thinking of when I was telling the story. His fucking dog died.
Yeah.
Okay. The next incident comes from Robert Richardson in 1967. Robert Richardson reported that he collided with a UFO while driving at night in Toledo, Ohio. On impact, the object vanished. Richardson took home a small lump of metal that he believed was from the UFO. A week later, Richardson said he was visited by two men in black suits. He said the two men asked for the piece of metal from the site, but when Richardson informed them that he had turned it over for testing, they threatened him. Quote, "If you want your wife to stay as pretty as she is, then you'd better get the metal back." And
I love that.
Richardson
line.
Never heard from the men again and still has no idea how they knew
that's
about the
totally
metal.
Correct.
Why didn't he go to the police? Why did he search on the internet? What do I do?
I think he may have gone to the police. There is no internet, by the way. It's 1967. He probably just searched. How many people searched back then? I don't know. Fucking
encyclopedias.
That's right!
The next encounter happened in New Jersey in 1968. Jack Robinson, a UFO researcher, and his wife Mary were terrorized by a man in black that would stand across the street from their apartment building. They reported their apartment appeared to be rummaged through, and after seeing the strange man for 3 days in a row, their friend, Timothy Green Beckley, decided to get a closer look and managed to snap the picture. This is a rare instance of a reported MIB caught on camera.
How do we know he's actually dressed in black if it's a black and white picture? Could be a dark movie.
These next encounters I'm going to go over are a little more bizarre and offer much stranger implications. On September 11th, 1976, Dr. Herbert Hopkins, a doctor living in Maine, was studying a UFO incident when he reportedly got a phone call from a man who identified himself as a representative of a New Jersey UFO organization. The man asked if Dr. Hopkins was alone and if they could review research. Dr. Hopkins agreed, and by the time he hung up the phone and turned on the lights outside, Dr. Hopkins claimed the man was somehow already coming up the stairs to his door. Hopkins' description of the man is the most horrifying yet. The man wore a neatly tailored black suit, was bald with no eyebrows or eyelashes, and had smooth, dead white plastic skin like a doll.
This is honestly starting to look
like a cult. Ruby red. And his speech was expressionless and monotone, as if you were hearing a machine.
He's got those Michael Jackson lips.
He's pale, really tight fake skin, but the thing they choose to make real is the ruby red lips. They put all their like technology into making those lips super realistic, but the rest of the man can't speak normal, and he looks horrible. Like his face is skin white. What?
The man in black told Hopkins to take out a coin and said, "Watch the coin." After that, Hopkins claims, quote, "It started to develop a silver color instead of copper, and then the silver became bluish, and the penny was getting quite fuzzy, out of focus, blurred, and then it simply was gone. It slowly dematerialized," end quote. After that, Hopkins said the man ordered him to destroy his UFO research.
Encounters like this, if they were real, they would not be this interesting.
If in the off chance this actually happened, how shitty would that be? If you tell a story, no one's gonna believe you, first off. And second off, you're gonna look like a crazy person. This next encounter is the story you probably know. Dan Aykroyd.
Yeah.
In January 2002, Dan Aykroyd told a TV show called Out There to the Sci-Fi Network that would break serious ground on a wide range of topics in the alien media landscape. In the middle of conducting further interviews for the show, Dan stepped outside for a break where he reported seeing a black Ford sedan appear suddenly across the street. Dan reports that one large man in black got out of the car and gave Dan a dirty look. Dan said he looked away for a brief second, and when he turned back, the car was gone. 2 hours after the car disappeared, Dan was given bad news from the producers of the show. Dan said, quote, "We were told we were not to continue taping, and the show was canceled, and none of them would air," end quote.
why is it not the government? Why is it some weird alien organization coming after them?
If that were to be true, that would mean that the government is in accordance with these aliens already.
So the Men in Black could show up at Obama's desk and be like, hey, stop looking for aliens. Yeah, PSV human.
But I saved the best encounter for last.
Okay.
On October 14, 2008, near Niagara Falls, hotel manager Shane Sovar, along with a hotel security guard, reported seeing a large triangular UFO outside his hotel. A group called the Aerial Phenomenon Investigations Team looked into the incident. They reported that a couple weeks later, according to three other witnesses, two unidentified men in black visited the hotel. The men in black terrified the hotel staff and were looking for Shane Sovar and the hotel security guard, who were luckily not there at the time. And when Shane Sovar reviewed the hotel security footage, he discovered that the camera had actually caught two men on tape. What we're about to watch is that footage.
No one's gonna die, are they?
No.
Right there.
Sovar reported that the witnesses described the men as tall with black suits, black hats, identical faces, extremely pale skin, no eyebrows, no eyelashes, and abnormally large eyes. A woman who spoke with the men claimed that she felt that the men knew what she was thinking. Is this video proof that the MIB exist? Or is this video simply an internet hoax?
Can I be 100% honest? Yeah. I'm really trying here. They just look like businessmen.
So you just think there's two abnormally large?
They were abnormally large?
They look.
Oh, look, they look the same. The one pixel, it's so blurry.
Okay, look at this fucking, this guy right here. The fucking guy standing next to the door.
Okay.
Look at him next to them. Unless he's super tiny.
Are basketball players aliens? Is Kobe? Is your precious Kobe an alien?
Oh, yeah, he might be, actually.
Yeah, he might be.
Unfortunately, most cases of UFO or alien encounters come in the form of first-person accounts. And the MIB are no different. Do they exist? Are they from the government? Are they even human? Ultimately, it comes down to what you believe. Me personally, I believe that while they may not be aliens, even I can't believe that, I do believe that there may be a government agency out there that would regulate these sort of things to prevent mass hysteria.
I can buy into the fact that the Men in Black may be a real thing, but I cannot give you the satisfaction that they are covering up aliens.
There are certain things like ghosts or aliens or demons that don't.
Well, no, I'd say if those exist, then that becomes part of the science, and there's an explanation behind those things.
See, this is
and
where
it's logical.
This is where we'll always disagree, because not everything can be explained by science or logic, in my opinion.
No. No!
One day, there's gonna be definitive proof of one of these
One day more!
There's gonna be definitive proof of something happening, and I'm gonna be there when that day happens, Brent.
And
I'm
this
gonna
is be when there. We know the video is
no,
over.
No, and that, I'm gonna be there, and you know, no, yeah, you can walk away like you always do, but one day, it's gonna happen, and trust me, sir, I will be there. And I won't even say anything, I'll just smile at you, like this.
Josh,
that's right. A very funny video.
Yeah.
That's,
oh, that's
funny. Thank you, Jackie.
What did you guys think of it?
I thought it was really funny. I loved it.
Hilarious.
I'll see you guys later.
See ya.
Yeah, see you later.
I'll make sure he logs off.
Come on, Josh. You have to log us out.
Don't worry, Aaron.
I think he doesn't realize he's the host.
Have a nice lunch, Aaron. Bye, Matt.
Bye. Oh, Debbie, have a nice lunch. Yeah,
have a nice lunch, everybody.
Yeah, lunchtime.
Okay,
bye. Lunchtime.
Yeah, 1:30.
Bye, Debbie.
Or 12:30.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye, Josh.
Bye.